Hello, and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on lattice energies. The lattice energy is the energy required to separate one mole of a solid ionic compound into its gaseous ions. And it's directly related to the force of attraction between oppositely charged particles. So it's directly related to the force of attraction between the negatively and positively charged ions composing the ionic compound. So in this equation, Q1 and Q2 are the charges on the ions, and D is the distance between the ions. So what does this mean? Well, it means that the lattice energy is directly related to the charge of the ions. So as the charge of the ions increases, the lattice energy will increase. And it's indirectly related to the size of the ions, or the distance between them. So as the ions get smaller, that also means that the lattice energy will increase. So lattice energy increases upon increasing charge of the ions and decreases upon increasing size of the ions. Now, while the distance between the ions plays a role in the lattice energy, the size of ions doesn't change significantly. So if you were comparing different compounds and trying to determine the relative magnitude of their lattice energies, the charges of the ions will have a greater effect on the lattice energy than the size of the ions, or the distance between them. Lattice energy cannot be calculated directly, and so how are lattice energies calculated? And so they calculate lattice energies by forming gaseous neutral atoms, forming ions from the gaseous atoms, and then combining the ions to form an ionic solid. You can then use Hess's law to indirectly calculate the lattice energy by combining the enthalpy changes from these three separate steps. Let's look at an example using lattice energies. Rank the following compounds in order of increasing lattice energy. First, let's locate where these elements are on the periodic table. And so what you'll notice is that because lithium, potassium, and sodium are all in group 1 of the periodic table, that means they all form ions with a charge of plus 1. And likewise, fluorine, chlorine, and bromine are all in group 7 of the periodic table, which means they all form ions with a charge of negative 1. So in this example, the charges of our ions remain constant, and so the difference in lattice energies is going to be due to the distance between the ions forming the compounds. And the distance between the ions forming the compounds is going to get bigger as the size of the ions increases. Remember that the size of ions increase as you go down your periodic table. And remember that increasing size corresponds to a decrease in lattice energy. So KBr will have the lowest lattice energy, followed by NaCl, and LiF will have the greatest lattice energy. Let's look at another example. Rank the following compounds in order of increasing lattice energy: magnesium oxide, sodium chloride, and potassium chloride. First, let's locate where these elements are in the periodic table. Here we have magnesium oxide, sodium chloride, and potassium chloride. So what if we're trying to compare compounds differing in both ion charge and size? Remember that the charge of ions has more of an effect on the lattice energy because the atomic radius and distance between ions does not vary significantly over a large range of ions. And so in this case, potassium chloride will have the lowest lattice energy because both potassium chloride and sodium chloride are composed of ions having charges of plus 1 and minus 1. And now the only difference between potassium chloride and sodium chloride is the presence of either the sodium or the potassium ion. Because the potassium ion is larger than the sodium ion, when comparing these two compounds that are composed of ions with the same charge, potassium chloride will have the lowest lattice energy because potassium is the larger ion. When comparing sodium chloride and magnesium oxide, sodium chloride is composed of ions with a charge of plus 1 and minus 1, where magnesium oxide is composed of ions having charges of plus 2 and minus 2, because magnesium is on the second group of the periodic table, and those elements form ions with a charge of plus 2, and oxygen is in the sixth group of the periodic table, and those elements form ions with a charge of minus 2. So in this case, magnesium oxide will have the greatest lattice energy. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.